It's snowing outside, I've got a nice hot cup of herbal tea, and I've got a side French braid. I guess that means I'm breaking down Frozen's Let It Go today. So full disclosure, I am a shameless lover of the song Let It Go. I don't care how overplayed it is. I don't care that everyone and their mother did a cover and a parody of it.
Light a stove, don't eat fast food anymore.
It's just objectively a really good song, and the lyrics in Japanese are very simple. And I think that it was localized very well into the Japanese language from English. Plus, it's a song that, whether you want to or not, I'm sure you're pretty familiar with it, and a lot of you guys probably already have it memorized in English. So if you memorize the Japanese version, it's an excellent language learning tool. I'm gonna break down not only what each individual Japanese word means and phrase means, but I'm also going to compare and contrast the localized Japanese version of the song versus the original English lyrics and explain how important localization is and show that sometimes things will be different when they're localized into another language and that that is totally okay. So first I want to just briefly address the title of the song. In English it is Let It Go, and in Japanese it is Ari no Mama. Ari no Mama is a phrase that means as I am, or, you know, as you are. It's pronoun free. But because she's singing this song pretty much in the first person about herself, it's as I am. So you may think, wow, Let It Go and as I am are completely different phrases. Why did they translate it that way? So to look at this, we have to look at the entire subtext of the song, what she's feeling while she's singing this song, what has pushed her emotionally to sing this song. In musical theater, you sing when like speaking just isn't enough to convey your emotion. So her emotion in this movie, she had just been exposed, her secret powers had just been exposed. She had been told all her life, hey, if you let people know you have those powers, like, you're a monster, you're gonna hurt people, don't let people know you have these powers. Suppress yourself, hide yourself. And it was making her very moody, very emo, very isolated, very lonely, and self-loathing. So in the English version, her takeaway from that when she breaks free of all of that is to let it go. And by let it go, mean give zero fucks about what everyone else is saying about you and your powers, and just let yourself be powerful. You have a gift, use it, shine, be powerful. Be the queen that you are. And that goes with the Western, especially American mindset of, like, you can be whatever you want to be, you know, don't care what other people say, be yourself. It's that kind of be yourself message. Whereas in the Japanese culture, they value putting the group's needs above your own. So in a way, the message of don't care about what other people say and just be powerful and all that, it doesn't quite resonate as well with them. That's almost seen as like a negative. But what is seen as a positive fantasy often is to be yourself. Because they're so put the needs of the group ahead of yourself, they often do like suppress who they really are. Mostly they suppress how they really feel, their honne, how they really feel about things. You know, in the name of being polite and considering how other people feel. And oftentimes that will result, especially for girls, of really just, you know, concealing how they really are, concealing how they really feel about things, and it also really makes their self-confidence hurt. So in the Japanese version, what's happening to Elsa in this scene, instead of, you know, not caring about what other people think and being powerful and just like, you know, laughing in the face of everyone who disagreed with her kind of feel to it, it's more a gentle, softer, self-love, self acceptance kind of song. And you'll see that come through a lot in the lyrics. So that's why the title is Ari no Mama, As I Am, basically love myself as I am, accept myself as I am, versus Let It Go, which is more like, it's still ultimately the same message of be yourself, let yourself shine, but it's more in the context of, you know, forget about what everyone else says and ditch all of your self-loathing and all of your insecurities that you had. They're not serving you well anymore. So now let's look at the first line. 降り始めた雪は足跡消して. So 降り始めた means began to snow. Furu, that verb, it's associated with rain and snow. Rain and snow are not verbs in Japanese. You say rain is falling or snow is falling. So, 降り始めた means began to snow. Yuki is snow, so the snow that began to fall. Wa means we're talking about the snow that began to fall. Ashi ato is footprints. And then keshite means to extinguish or to erase. So ashi ato keshite means like to erase your footprints. So the snow that began to fall is erasing my footprints or the footprints. 真っ白な世界に Mashirona means pure white. Sekai is world. Hitori means alone, one person. And then watashi is me. So mashirona sekai ni, in a world that is pure white, hitori no watashi means I am alone. Or hitori no means like you're turning alone into an adjective. So I'm alone. Kaze ga kokoro ni sasayaku. Kaze is wind, kokoro means either your heart, mind, or soul. Sasayaku is to whisper. So kaze ga kokoro ni sasayaku means the wind or a breeze is whispering into my heart or into my mind. And then the no at the end of the sentence is just like a feminine sort of ending to a sentence. But it's a little bit emphatic, like, yes, this wind is whispering into my soul. Kono mama ja means at this rate. Dame means no good. Nanda is like this, very affirming, like, yes, I know this to be true, ending to a sentence. And then to is like quotation marks. So, kono mama ja dame nanda is in quotes. Basically, that is what the wind is saying. It's saying, you can't go on like this. So if we look at that entire paragraph, translated into English, I translated it as... I translated this translation as, the freshly fallen snow erases my footprints. In this blank white world, I am all alone. The wind whispers in my heart, you can't keep this up forever. Whereas the original English lyrics was, the snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like the swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I've tried. So a note. Couple notes, actually. In English, we try to rhyme as often as possible in our song lyrics, but in Japanese, they don't really bother with that, and a lot of it's because their language almost always ends words and sentences on a vowel. That's just how their language is, and they only have 5 vowels, so the likelihood of lines just rhyming anyway is pretty high, so they usually don't bother with rhyming. So that's the first thing you might notice. The second thing that you might notice is that, well, you might not notice this, so I'm telling you, is that in English, our words are a lot shorter. It takes much fewer syllables to say something, but in Japanese, it takes much more syllables to say the same thing. So you might notice that there's less information in the Japanese version of this first paragraph. So the snow glows white on the mountain tonight. There's no mountain. There's no mention of a mountain in the Japanese version. Probably just not enough syllables for it. But they have the white snow, not a footprint to be seen. The footprints are erased, basically the same thing. A kingdom of isolation, that's very poetic. I really like that lyric, but they don't literally translate it that way. That would be like kodoku no kuni. That would be a kingdom of isolation. So, I mean, that's not that many syllables. They could have done that. And it looks like I'm the queen of this. Instead, they say, in this blank white world, I'm all alone. So yeah, they were busy saying that it's a blank white world from the line before because they couldn't fit that into the line before. So all they had room for was to just say that she's alone. The wind is howling like the swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in. Heaven knows I tried. Versus the wind whispers in my heart. You can't keep this up forever. That's very different, if you'll notice. And again, in the original English version, if you listen to that language, Elsa's raging inside. She's very bitter from the way she was treated her entire life. And she, you know, lost her temper. That's kind of how she's seeing this. Whereas in the Japanese version, there's no trace of that. There's no trace of her anger, her resentment, her bitterness. And instead, it's more just the wind whispers in my heart that you can't keep this up forever. Couldn't keep it in. Heaven knows I've tried. It's kind of a similar sentiment to that. But that's kind of sarcastic, right? And then the Japanese version, it's more that the wind is, you know, gently whispering into her heart, hey, you can't do this forever. You're gonna reach a breaking point. And now the next line. Tomadoi means to falter, to be confused, to be lost. Kizutsuki means to be hurt. Dare ni mo means to no one or not to anyone. Uchiakezu ni, uchiakeru would be to open up. to someone. Uchiakezu ni means the opposite of that. So unable to or not opening up to anyone. Nayandeta. So nayamu means to agonize or to stress or to worry. Nayanderu means to be stressing, agonizing, or worrying. And then nayandeta is the past tense of that. So was agonized, was stressing, was worried. So I was worried and stressed, unable to open up to anyone. それももやめよう. Sore is in reference to not being able to open up to anyone. So sore means like that thing that I was talking about earlier. That's the sore in this case. And then mo means like also. And yameyo means I'm going to give that up. I'm going to stop it. Sore mo mo yameyo means I'm just going to give that up. So looking at the original English, don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. And so the first three lines are basically just her repeating what has been drilled into her entire life. Like, hide who you really are, you're a monster, you know, be a good girl. Whereas in the Japanese version, it's more focusing on her sad emotions. I was lost, I was hurt, I couldn't open up to anybody. So again, it's this less defiant sort of screw you, mom and dad, feeling, and more just, I'm so sad, I'm so, it's more a softer kind of feel rather than a bitter, angry kind of feel to it. And then the original English version, well, now they know, and then she throws her glove off. That's a really cool moment, actually. I really like that part. And again, it's more a defiant, sarcastic, well, now they know, so fuck it, I'm just gonna be powerful. Whereas in the Japanese version, it's time to stop that. I'm gonna put a stop to that right now. So it's less bitter. It's more just inspirational, I'm gonna be myself kind of feel to it. And now the earworm of a chorus. Ari no mama no means as I am, and then the no at the end of that makes it like an apostrophe S after that whole thought. Sugata means like the way you appear or the way you are. So ari no mama no sugata means appear as you are. Miseru means to show. So ari no mama no sugata miseru means like I'm gonna show myself the way I really am. And then the noyo at the end of that is like, it's like kind of an imperative command, like, okay, Elsa, show them who you really are, the way you really are. That's what you should do. Ari no mama no, again, jibun means yourself, oneself. Jibun ni naru means to become. So, ari no mama no jibun ni naru means to become yourself the way you really are. To become your true self. And again, the no at the end is kind of a soft, feminine sort of imperative. Like, yes, I'm going to become my true self. Nani mo kowaku nai is a phrase that means I'm not scared of anything. Kaze yo. Fuke. So this is kind of poetic, it's like a poetic speech. So kazeyo means like dear winds or oh winds, that kind of feel to it. Fuke means keep blowing, you know, winds blow on. I'm not afraid of anything. Okay, and this is very clever. I love this localized line. The first time I saw it, I was like, eee! So you know the iconic, the cold never bothered me anyway, you know that line? You have little girls being like, cold never bothered me anyway, it was cute. In Japanese, 少しも寒くないわ. The reason why I love this, it still has that tone of defiance. 少しも寒くないわ means I'm not even slightly cold. And the wa at the end is this very feminine yet emphatic kind of ah-ha-ha in your face kind of feel to it. So the tone matches that super, super well with the cold never bothered me anyway. But the other thing that's really cool is, if you'll notice, the way the mouth moves in saying both of those phrases, some of the key syllables match up in Japanese and English. So sukoshi, the cold, so that works. That's like an emphasized syllable that matches up. The cold never bothered sukoshi mo sa muku. So those also match up. And then anyway, naiwa. If you look at my lips, it's practically the same thing. So I think that's extremely clever, that localization right there. So in the original English lyrics, let it go, can't hold it back anymore, let it go, turn away and slam the door. So again, this is a very sort of like, forget everyone else, I'm gonna go do my thing and be powerful. Whereas in Japanese, it's a softer, show them all who you really are, become the person you were meant to be, nothing scares me anymore, may the winds continue to blow, the cold doesn't bother me at all, or I'm not even slightly cold. So this whole let the storm rage on, the storm is her, her emotions, her very passionate feelings that she's had to conceal her entire life. Let the storm rage on. And then this kaze o fuke, it's probably in reference to that kaze at the beginning of the lyrics when she's talking about the kaze, the wind that was whispering in her ear, you can't keep this up forever. So that wind, that might have symbolized like her inner thoughts. But again, in English, it's a storm. Whereas in Japanese, it's a wind, you know, whispering. It's a more gentle feeling. All right, on to verse number two. Nayandeta, so we already learned that means was agonizing, was stressed, and then you add koto to the end of that, and that turns it into a concept, like the fact that I was agonizing. Usomitai, it's an expression that means it's hard to believe. It literally means it's like a lie, because uso means lie, but really in good English it's hard to believe. And then the ne at the end of that is a soft sort of like, whoa, dude, it's hard to believe that I was so stressed out before. Datte means sort of like, because, you know, because, dude, what I'm about to say. Mo jiyu yo, that means I'm already free. Jiyu means free. Nan demo dekiru, it's an expression that means I can do anything. Dokomade means how far. So dokomade yareru ka means how far can I go. Jibun, again, myself, oneself. Jibun wo tamesu means to test myself. So jibun wo tameshitai means I want to test myself. And then the no at the end of that, again, it's the emphatic feminine. Come on, dad, I want to do this thing. That kind of feel to it. Soyo means like, yeah, that's right. Kawaru no yo, that means you're gonna change or I'm gonna change. And then she adds watashi after that. Now, this is where most amateur translators would translate that as like I or me. But this is a weird thing. In Japanese, if you say, if it's a character's inner thoughts, and they're saying, you know, yaru no yo, watashi, or ganbare yo, watashi, they're not literally saying, like, do it, me, or hang in there, me. A much better translation, if we were doing that in English, it would be like, hang in there, Sarah, you can do it, Sarah. It's like, if your name is Sarah, like me. So a better translation of this line is, it's like, yes, Elsa, you're gonna change. So compare that to the English. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small. So it's hard to believe that I was in so much pain before. It's kind of the same sentiment, really. And in both cases, she's reflecting like, wow, I feel so much lighter now. And like 10 minutes ago, I was like sobbing. And it's hard to believe that. And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all turns into, because I'm already free now, I can do anything. Again, in the English version, it's focusing a little bit more on how oppressed she was, how her parents kept putting her down and making her scared, and those around her kept putting her down and making her scared all her life. And she also kept putting herself down and making herself scared. And, you know, those fears that once controlled her can't get to her anymore. But in the Japanese version, it's more like, I was free all along, and, you know, look at how talented I am, kind of thing. Like, I can do anything. Also, nandemodekiru, it's also a very common, like, you can do anything. It's very common in shoujo anime and manga, like girls anime and manga, to you know, have that powerful, positive message for girls, like, you can do anything. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and breakthrough becomes, I want to test my limits to see how far I can go. That's basically the exact same thing in both languages. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Versus, yes, Elsa, you're going to change now. Completely different, right? So the whole I'm free in the original English, they inserted that a little bit earlier in the phrase, in the I'm already free, I can do anything line. But this whole no right, no wrong, no rules, that's very revolutionary in Japanese culture. They have a very strong, like, this is right, this is wrong, and these are the rules, and you're gonna follow them. So I think it would have been a little too much for Elsa in the Japanese version to be like, no right, no wrong, no rules, I'm a renegade. It's like, that would make her not really a soft, feminine Disney heroine anymore, and it would make her more like, you know, Walter White or something in their eyes. So, they made it just very generic and simple, like, yes, Elsa, you're going to change. Which is still consistent with the messaging of the whole song, like she's gonna change into her true self. But again, in the English version, it's more like a screw everyone else, you know, and their rules and society, like, I'm gonna be my own person. And then the chorus again. So, ari no mama de means like, while being in the state of as I am. Sorae kaze ni notte. So, kaze ni noru means to like ride a gust of wind. So, this wind is coming up again. Again, it's not a storm, it's a gust of wind. It's gentler and softer. Sorae means to the sky or to the heavens. So, I'm gonna ride a gust of wind to the sky, to the heavens, as I am. And then ari no mama de, again, tobidashite miru no. Tobidasu means like to take flight, oftentimes like to take flight on a journey. And then if you add miru to the end of that, it becomes like I'm going to try to do this thing. So I'm gonna try to take flight as I am. Nidoto means never again. Namida is tears. And then nagasanai means to not let flow. Namida o nagasu means to cry, basically. So nidoto namida wa nagasanai wa means never again will I cry. And again, it has that wa at the end of that, that very defiant feminine, like, I'm never gonna do this again. So comparing that to the original English, let it go, let it go. I am one with the wind and sky becomes I'm going to ride a current of wind to the sky. Similar. Let it go, you'll never see me cry. That thought comes in at the end of the Japanese chorus. So they kind of just add this other thought in there. I'm gonna ride a current of wind to the sky as I am. I want to fly as far away as I can as I am. And then you're never gonna see me cry again. That thought comes. So in the English version, here I stand and here I stay, let the storm rage on. That's just not even in the Japanese chorus because there's like not enough room. They left that out. And again, here I stand and here I stay. That's a defiant, I'm making a stand. I'm claiming this is my new territory. I'm gonna build a castle here. It's kind of, you know, a revolution, really. It's like a political revolution. It's like I'm seceding from this kingdom and I'm gonna establish my ice castle here and be the queen. It's a bit too revolutionary for the Japanese version. So it's more, I'm never gonna cry again for that grand moment of stepping in the ice. And then the whole let the storm rage on thing again. We're not really letting storms rage on in the Japanese version. We're being a lot softer and more gentle. All right, now the bridge. Sumetaku means coldly. Sumetai is cold, and then if you add a ku, it's coldly. Daiichi is the earth, as in like dirt. Tsutsumikomi is to gather. So gathering the cold earth into my hands. Takaku means highly, again. Takai is high, and then takaku is like highly is an adverb. Mayagaru is to dance up, literally, but it means like to fly up. Omoi, in this case, if you look at the kanji, it's a little different from the omoi that means to think. This is feelings, the feelings kind of omoi. Gaite means to draw or to paint. Hanasaku is to bloom, like a flower specifically, but to bloom. Kori is ice, so hanasaku kori is blooming ice. Kesho is crystal, so hanasaku kori no kesho is a blooming ice crystal. And then put brackets around that thought, add a no, so that makes it an apostrophe s after the brackets. And then yo ni means like a, so kind of reverse that, kind of flip-flop that. So, like a blooming ice crystal. Kagayaiteitai. Kagayaku means to shine. Kagayaiteru means like to be shining. And then kagayaiteitai, if you add the tai at the end to something, it means I want to. So it means I want to be shining, literally. Or I want to shine in better English. Mo kimeta no, that's a phrase that means I've already made my decision or there's no turning back. So let's compare to the original English. My power flurries through the air into the ground. Okay, so this is going back to the whole theme where in the English version it's more about Elsa's power than about her self-love. So in the Japanese it's she's gathering cold earth into her hands versus her power flurrying. My soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. I like that line a lot. And in the Japanese, it's more, I'll send my feelings or my soul basically dancing into the sky as ice crystals basically. And one thought crystallizes like an icy blast becomes, and just like a blooming crystal of ice, similar but different. And then this thought that crystallizes like an icy blast is, I'm never going back, the past is in the past. And in the Japanese, it's, I want to shine. I've already decided that I want to shine and there's no turning back. So again, in the English version, it's more like I'm gonna burn my bridges. I'm gonna say goodbye to the life and the country that screwed me over and made me so sad, alone, insecure, hate myself so much. The past is in the past, I'm leaving it behind. Versus in the Japanese version, it's more that I'm gonna shine now. There's no resentment there. It's just, I'm gonna shine. Now we're finally deviating from Ari no Mama and we're changing the lyrics a little bit. And I like this. I like that resolution. Hearing let it go at the beginning of every chorus does get quite a bit monotonous. Kore de ii no. This means like, it's okay the way it is. This is for the best. Jibun wo suki ni natte. That's a very common phrase in shoujo anime and manga. So jibun wo suki ni naru means to like yourself. Or to like become a person who likes yourself. It's more that kind of feeling. Jibun wo shinjite. Again, a very common phrase in shoujo anime and manga. So to believe in yourself, basically. Means light. Abinagara is meaning while bathing. So while bathing in light. Arukidaso. Arukidasu means to walk forward, to move on, to journey, to sally forth. And then if you change the su to soul, it's more a let's do this kind of feel to it. So while bathing in light, I'm gonna march onward. And then 少しも寒くないわ, again, like I'm not even slightly cold. So compared to the original English, let it go, again, it gets quite monotonous by then. And I'll rise like the break of dawn. I like that line, it's a good line. I will love myself. It's very different, right? And again, I'm sounding like a broken record, but I will rise like a break of dawn. It's very powerful, it's very empowering. It's like, I will rise, you know? Isn't that like a Maya Angelou poem? I think so. But yeah, it's like this very empowering, I'm gonna rise like a break of dawn, like the frickin' sun. That's how powerful I am. Versus in the Japanese version, I will learn to love myself. And then let it go, that perfect girl is gone. So again, this idea of you all were trying to shape me into something that I'm not and it tore me apart. And it's a sarcastic feeling to it. That perfect girl, well, she's gone, she's history. It's a defiant, sarcastic feel to it, whereas in the Japanese, 自分を信じて, it's like, I'm gonna believe in myself. It's very, very different. Here I stand in the light of day, that's actually quite similar. While I'm bathing in light, let the storm rage on, I'm going to move on with my life, or I'm going to walk forward. Different, right? Let the storm rage on, it's like, I'm going to embrace my anger, because that's where a lot of my power comes from. I'm going to embrace, like, this torrent of feelings and stuff inside of me. Versus in the Japanese, it's just, I'm gonna move on with my life as the new me kind of feeling to it. It's still an empowering image and feel to it, but different a little bit. And then the cold never bothered me anyway, versus I'm not even slightly cold, which again is basically the same sentiment. So as you can see, a lot of thought goes into localizing cartoons or anime, and especially when it comes to songs and music, because you have to consider fitting syllables in, and you have to consider the cadence of everything and make sure that everything flows really well. So a lot of the differences in this song, well, they were cultural, and they were changed to appeal more to a Japanese audience. I'm sure a lot of the changes were also just simply, well, this word fits syllabically better than this other word, or well, this phrase fits syllabically a lot better than the other word. And they don't worry about it so much in Japanese dubbing, but sometimes it's also nice to make sure that the vowels that the character is saying match up. So like, let it go, ari no, mama no. The fact that the vowel matches up is also nice, and they try to do that whenever it makes sense. So thanks for watching my Let It Go, Ari no Mama tutorial. If you want to see me do more Disney songs specifically, let me know in the comments. I'm open to suggestions. I am, of course, also open to suggestions for anime songs, which is what I was originally doing.